right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Karim Rayani, the CEO of MARV Discovery Corp. And Karim, good to have you back again. How are you?
Good, Steve. Good to see you.
Lots of stuff to talk about with you. First off, we got some news out about one of your projects, Blackfly. And maybe you can just remind everyone, this one's in Ontario, right?
Correct. Based on some of our other interviews on Falcon, the Blackfly project is on the Hammond Reef Fault, which is adjacent to Agnico Eagle's Hammond Reef's 4.6 million ounce deposit. This is contiguous right on the same extension.
And you've received some permitting now from the government. So this permit allows you to basically start your 2021 exploration program. So give me an idea about what's going to happen there this year.
So our game plan is to drill up to 2,000 meters. This property has a rich mining history dating back to 1898. It was one of the first gold discoveries in Atikokan. We were very fortunate to be able to acquire this. The gold market the last 9 months has been on a little bit of a downtrend here, and it was in the private prospecting family. A shaft was put in at that time, grades anywhere from 80 to 167 grams per ton at the shaft. It's a 5 kilometer extension that we're going after. Very high grade, never been drilled down to 200 to 300 meters. The last drilling was done by Terex in 2012. They were averaging anywhere between 5 and 20 grams on their holes. So most of this drilling is current, so we'll be able to use a lot of that data moving forward.
Yeah, so it's going to be systematic, right? You do some trenching and line cutting, getting it set, and then bring the drills in sometime in the summer?
The crew is actually on the ground right now.
Okay.
Trenching should be done here in the next week, and we anticipate drilling within 30 days.
All right. Well, thanks for the update on that one. Karim, I want to ask you about something else. You've also acquired some land around another one of your projects. And this is all connected to what we talked about recently about the Power One spin out.
Correct. So, we managed to acquire 15 claim blocks covering 5,000 hectares. It is directly tied on to Power One's ground, which was formerly MARV. That project has a 20 million ton resource of uranium U308, working out to roughly 14 million pounds. So this ground is directly in the middle of that deposit. And to the right, you have Canadian palladium and you have grid metals, which have been having tremendous success hitting some of the richest palladium numbers across the board. The reason for this is, we thought it would be a good idea to tie up any remaining lands, before we start drilling. I believe that this is one of the hottest areas right now for uranium and rare earths. And now we have palladium. So, the story is adding, more and more to it as we go by.
Yeah. And you mentioned that you're going to start drilling there. Is that going to be probably into next year before you get to the drills in the ground?
Depending on how long it takes to get Power One up and going, we anticipate 4 to 6 months. And depending on weather, it would be brilliant if we could get a drill on there in the next 6 to 10 months.
All right, good stuff. Karim, very busy for you. Thank you so much. Appreciate the update, and we'll keep an eye on things as they continue to unravel this season. So thanks very much.
Thanks, Steve. Talk soon.
All right, there's Karim Rayani, the CEO of MARV Discovery Corp.